there's someone here this morning, you've been having problems with the, it's like the, a gag reflex. You know, the gag reflex is normal. It's healthy when it functions right. Like when I try to eat liver, it stops me, and I'm okay with that. But it's almost like it's not functioning right. It's like that part of your, there's something wrong in your swallowing in that area. Where are you this morning? Is this you? Okay, can you come up? Thank you, Lord. How many know that can be a nuisance if you're not swallowing right? So, ¿cuánto tiempo tiene tu problema?
Como una semana.
Oh, 1 week.
Does it bother you more sometimes than other times? Okay. Can you do that? Let's pray. Father, we just release your healing power right now in Jesus' name. I command this to be healed. I command it to function normally in the name of Jesus. Tócala. Tócala en el nombre de Jesús. Más poder para sanidad. Llénala. Llénala en el nombre de Jesús. Now let me ask you, are you feeling anything? What are you sensing?
Well, actually, when you were saying it was in pain.
Uh-huh.
And right now I don't feel pain.
So it was actually, there was actually pain.
Right.
So did you have a problem swallowing food?
I just feel like there's something there.
Okay.
That's causing the
and how does it feel now?
I'm not feeling the pain.
Okay, so it's like something is happening.
Yes, I
okay.
Yeah.
How can you tell if it's healed? Would eating food help, or is that not really the?
I don't think it was the eating food. I just felt like there was something there.
And the pain is gone.
Yes.
Gloria a Dios.
Interpret.
Gloria a Dios. Interpret. Glory to God.
Yes.
Can I share something?
Yes.
Okay, I just wanna share something real quick. It's about faith. So it's kind of a testimony, but anyways, I just feel I should release it. So before I met Daniel, I make a card to God, like a little kid, like, okay, this is the kind of man that I would like. So I make a letter with like all these like points and top it off, like, I would like, I think it would be super amazing if you, you know, something Jewish. And I'm like, okay, I'm asking for a Christian, but how can that be? I could not in my brain. I was like, that doesn't work, but okay, I'll just leave my letter like that. It took 5 years to be answered. But I felt like, you know, I felt like when the Lord started, I didn't know about Holy Spirit until actually closer when I get to meet Daniel. Then I was like, oh, there is Holy Spirit. It's not just that dope that I thought it was there. It's actually someone. And so then it's like these boys that I knew now, it's like, oh, that's you. One day I met this girl. And, she was fine. She was young. And it started like a joke. She's like, oh, you know, she's like my mother-in-law, but she doesn't know it. He's like, you know, his son is my boyfriend, but he doesn't know it. And I just felt like the Holy Spirit was telling me that's faith. So I'm like, okay, I've been asking you for my husband. I'm going to start looking in all the shops for my wedding dress. I don't have a boyfriend yet, but I'm going to start trying all those dresses and looking in magazines. So I start my search in magazines and I start trying my dresses, and everybody in the store were like, well, when is the wedding? We don't have a date yet, but it's very soon. They probably thought it was crazy. I was like, it's very soon. And then in Mexico, it's like, you know, after you're 20, they kind of start calling you señora. You know, like you're not, you know, you're not in the youth group anymore. So that kind of started bugging me, but I was like, okay, maybe I should just change that. Okay, Lord, I think they're prophesying over me. I'm senora now. I'm married and I have my family now. Let it be that way, okay. I'll take it. And my boss would, you know, she would get angry and she'll be correcting that, guys. Do not call her that. She's senorita. And I'm like, no, he's prophesying over me. Let him prophesy over me. And then God started sending people on my way, talking about knowledge and then talking to me about Daniel without me knowing him. And then shortly after that, like, it happened so quick. Then it's I met him within a week free propose. And then we got married, and on our wedding, that was also totally him. I was picturing this wedding beautiful and, you know, with bunch of flowers. And I remember all my relatives and friends were like, you know, she does not even have a boyfriend.
Loco.
And she's totally like out there. So I started looking at these places, and they were shining down. I was like, well, I don't know. I want a gazebo, God. I don't know. I want a gazebo. I don't know what's up with a gazebo, but I think it will be super cool, a gazebo. And anyway, so without money, because we didn't have money, Daniel was studying. And I was working, but it was, I have to provide for my family. So it's like, forget about that part. So in that day, actually, you know, the guy that gave me word of prophecy and told me about Daniel, he's like, I bless your generations. So I'm like, oh, are you talking that I'm going to be married to him and have children or something? Or are you blessing my generations? I'm like, all right. But, you know, that word of knowledge that he had for me, he told things that I need to be healed. I would never even told, like, seriously, not even a friend. I would be like, and I was like, you and you're a boy and you're telling me all these things that I only know? I'm like, that's totally God. So, on my wedding day, he totally show up. The girl that I asked for prices and I couldn't afford her, you know, only in her store, only like a little bouquet decoration. It was like my budget. And she totally blessed me. She took her store stuff and decorated the whole, my place. She decorated the whole thing. So when I arrived to that place, it was like, you know, my mom was even shocked because she was like, you know, where is all this coming from? And my family, I think they were all like, wow, how did you do it without money? God just totally show up. And I remember I was crying the night before and I'm like, God, you know, my daddy's with you. You know, he was the one that provided, so it's you. You know how I want my wedding? And I remember that I told him like that, so you're not going to fail me. You're not going to let your daughter, because I'm a princess, you're not going to let all of them laugh about me saying, oh, you know, there's nothing here. He totally showed up and everyone actually was like surprised. He's like, they were even asking me, where did you pull that guy from? I was like, they were asking my mom, like, how did this happen and we didn't know that she even had a boyfriend? It's totally him. So yeah, I encourage you to believe, you know, whatever you are believing, God, just don't give up, you know? And I feel I am believing for my family and for other things. And my mother-in-law, she's been a huge anchor for us. And I would say for me, especially. And she came one day and shared about the circle maker. So I'm like, I'm going to start claiming the land. So Daniel and I have been praying over a piece of land and I'm like, so I have been going, walking around, and I already have received comments like, you know, there's one guy that came and he's like, he saw me there. I start having my quiet time, singing to the Lord. I'm like, I'm pretending nobody's here. It's just you and me. Because usually I would try to go early after I drop my kid, and there's like pretty much they open like at 10, so I'm way early than everybody else. But then this guy was there, and he was inside his truck. I could hear a truck there, and I'm like, okay, Lord, I don't think I like being watched by this truck here, but I will just ignore the truck. And I'm here, I'm going to bless this land, I'm going to bless north, south, And I'm like, I'm just here, you know, I'm going to bless it. And I would release heaven. And I was doing that and worshiping. And then he approached. I guess he was curious, like, what is she doing? And he approached me and he's like, hey, so I kind of heard, like, he was asking, are you stoned? And I'm like, I don't think he could be asking that. Maybe I'm just hearing wrong. I'm like, I'm going to ask, maybe, you know, my English sometimes, has, if they talk too fast, maybe I was like, maybe it's one of those things. So I'll ask him again. It's like, sorry, what did you say? And then he's like, well, I was just wondering if your car is working. I was parked there, but I was like, well, my car is not, might not be the nicest one, but still works. I'm like, yeah, it's working, but thank you, you're so kind. And then he started asking me, and he's like, but I could feel like, you know, there was something there. Like, okay, all right, well, I was just wondering. I was like, sure. And then there's another girl that she works in the place besides. So she would just look at me like, what are you doing? You're just walking around. Maybe she thought it was stalking the place or something, right? And then one day I took my mother-in-law, and so she got to look at my mother-in-law. And then next time that I went there, and you know, I'm walking, praying around, and claiming, and just releasing God there. And she came to me, and she's like, "Hey, I just was so curious about what were you doing every morning here. So I knew Jackie, because that's my mother-in-law. She's like, I had to ask her, what's what you are doing there?" So she explained me. She explained me about the circle maker, and she explained me what you were doing there. That's so cool. She's like, that's so cool. I'm praying for you. And I'm like, oh, thank you. But yeah, whatever you are believing for, you know, God, God is there, and he has a time, and he will make it happen. Yeah.
Thank you, Betty. Hey, how's your throat doing?
It's not hurting.
No hurt. Okay. No hay dolor.